Hello and welcome to a POSCatch.com presentation, and today we are going to show you how to easily and cost-effectively do time and attendance tracking with a simple 1D barcode, and of course you'll also need a barcode scanner, and to be able to do the tracking itself with a simple formula in an Excel spreadsheet. So let's get right to it, and let's start the creation of the barcode itself. So what you want to do is you're going to want to open up your Microsoft Edge browser. And the reason why it's recommended for you to use the Microsoft Edge browser is because our barcode generator works best in the Microsoft Edge browser. So you want to go to our website, which is poscatch.com. That's poscatch.com. And then scroll down the page. And over here, you'll see a 1D barcode. It says click here to make free 1D barcodes. Go ahead and click on the barcode generator image. And this takes you to our barcode generator, to where we can now start the creation of your tracking barcode. So what you want to do is use a code 128 auto, which is the default barcode symbology or type that's listed here. So you want to use the default code 128 auto. By the way, code 128, you can actually have up to 128 characters in this barcode, but in this example, we of course won't use that many. Also, too, code 128 can input the full range of ASCII characters, which, as you can see, you can do text, numbers, and also additional characters. So, for example, let's just say that you have an employee by the name of John Smith. Okay, see that? And then maybe John has an employee number of 1234. So you can encode all of that into a code 128 barcode. But also, let's just say that you can do last name, first name, which is Smith John. Okay. And that's your tracking barcode right there. So the way to format this to the right size, because that's actually a rather large barcode, you want to bring your bar width down to 1. Okay, and then your height down to around 50. That's about the perfect size right there. You can change the font size here if you'd like down here, but that's about right the way it is. You can also change the coloring here. However, we don't recommend it. It's best to keep the traditional black lines with the white contrasted background. That's the easiest color coding for a barcode scanner to read. Okay, so once you have the desired barcode that you want with the data and also the formatting, what you want to do is right click on it, and then you do save picture as. And that will save this as a .png file. And we've already done this here for you. So we're going to open this up and go ahead and import that into Microsoft Word or some other application to be able to print these out. Okay. So once you have that done, the next thing you want to do is test it. So I actually have printed out one of these already. And I have a USB barcode connected to my machine here. So I'm just going to open up Notepad. And there you go. See that? Scans right in. Smith John. Now, of course, if you had other data in there, that would also show as well. So we know that barcode works. So let's go ahead and open up Excel. So what we're going to want to do is set up Excel to where we can do a very easy tracking for time and attendance. So to do the date time stamp, normally the way you would do it is put in a formula like this would be equals now and then parentheses. And then as you can see, it automatically inputs the current time. that is on this machine that I'm using now. So it has the current time date of the machine that I'm using now. And then what you can do is you can go ahead and scan in Smith John. See that there? So, but let's just say that you want to go ahead and have this automatic. So every time when you go ahead and scan in here, you want this to be updated as well. So let's go ahead and change the formula. So I already have a formula here. I'm going to go ahead and put in here. Okay, let's do this. Okay, so this is the formula right here, and I'll actually, this formula is in the bottom of this YouTube video that you're looking at. So if you look down to the details under the bottom of this YouTube video, you can see this formula up here, okay? So basically what we wanna do is we wanna copy this formula down, okay? And then let's go ahead and we'll scan again. And see that? It says we're getting an error message. And the reason why we're getting an error message is because we need to change a setting in this Excel spreadsheet. So let's go ahead and click OK. And then we're going to go to formulas. And then we're going to do enable this calculation right here. Okay. And then we're going to click OK. Right. And then now the next time that we scan, this should go ahead and work. Let's see. There we go. You see that? So we have an automatic update every time that you scan that barcode that we created. You have an automatic update in column A that goes ahead and updates this. So let's see, the time just changed to 18 minutes past the hour. So I'm gonna go ahead and scan this again so you can see that the time got updated. So let's do this again. See that there? So it changed from 17 to 18 minutes past the hour. Now, this is a very quick and easy and inexpensive way to do time and attendance tracking with a 1D barcode with a simple USB barcode scanner, and to do the tracking in an Excel spreadsheet. And by the way, for the barcode scanner to scan in, you want to make sure that you have carriage return enabled so it keeps going down to the next line. If you don't have carriage return enabled on your barcode scanner, you will definitely want to get that turned on so you'll be able to do an automatic enter down to the next line. If you have any further questions about this video, please don't hesitate to contact us directly or leave a comment in the YouTube comments below for this video, and we'll be more than happy to get back to you. Thank you so much and have a great day.